The scheme that we will describe is based on linear codes. Let us first review two ideas that we need from linear codes in order to describe this reconciliation scheme. The first element that we need is the parity check matrix. A parity check matrix is just an n by n matrix, in our case with binary entries. The second element is the syndrome of a string. Given a string x, the syndrome of x is the string that results from multiplying the parity check matrix H with the transpose of x. Now, let's go back to the reconciliation scheme. First, we will zoom into the encoding step performed by Alice. The reconciliation scheme is based on linear codes. Given a parity check matrix H and Alice's vector xA, the encoding of xA is its syndrome. That is, the message that Alice sends to Bob for information reconciliation is the syndrome of xA. Let us make this idea clear with an example. Let us assume that we have the string of length 3001 and the parity check matrix is the one given here. Then we can easily compute the syndrome of x. We multiply h with x transpose and we can easily verify that we obtain the string 01. What this means is that if x were the string of Alice, the message that Alice would send to Bob for reconciliation would be the syndrome of x, which as we calculated is 01. Let us now move to Bob and his decoder. The decoder is a little bit more complicated. It takes as input both CA and XB. The first thing that happens in the decoder is that it computes the syndrome of XB that we call CB. Then CB gets added to CA, the syndrome of XA. We call the resulting string CS. We call it CS because it is indeed the syndrome of the error string. That is the result of multiplying the parity check matrix with the bit string S. We will prove this little fact later. For the moment, let's believe it. Then CS is sent into a module that estimates the error string S and outputs the estimate that we call S hat. Finally, S hat is added to XB, and this will be the decoded string that Bob will receive. A first important comment is that XA hat is exactly xA plus the difference between the estimated error and the real error vector. This is very easy to prove. First, we write xA hat as xB plus s hat, and then we write xB as xA plus s. What this means is that if the estimate is correct, xA hat will equal xA. Now, let us get some intuition into the different elements in the decoder by continuing with the previous example. So let's consider two values for the string of Alice, xA, for instance 000 and 110. Then an easy matrix multiplication gives us that their syndromes are 00 and 01. Let us also consider two arbitrary error strings S, for instance 001 and 011. We can also compute the syndrome of the error strings, which are 01 and 10. We can now also compute the strings of Bob, XB, which are obtained by summing xA plus s, and we get 001, 011, 111, and 101. Now the syndromes of xB, which are 01, 10, 00, and 11. And finally, CS, which is obtained by summing CA and CB. And voila, we obtain 01, 10, 01, 10, exactly equal as the syndrome of S. So after these computations, we can observe that, as suggested before, CS seems to only depend on the error string. We can prove very easily that CS is indeed the syndrome of the error string S. For this, let us write CS as CA plus CB. And CA equals the parity check matrix H times XA, and CB is H times XB. So this then equals H times XA plus XB, and XA plus XB is nothing else than S. Another trivial but relevant property of the scheme is that as soon as the length of the string that Alice sends Bob is smaller than the length of the string of Alice, not all errors can be corrected. In order to see this, recall that XA hat is XB plus S hat, but S hat is a function of CS, the syndrome of S. Hence, even if the estimator function outputs a different value for each syndrome, we have 2 to the n different outputs, while there are 2 to the n different error strings. In other words, unless m equals n, it is not possible to correct all errors. But of course, if different errors occur, With different probabilities, we might be satisfied if we correct the most likely errors. So now let us go back to our example. We defined the encoding function, but we have not yet completed the description of the decoder. For this, we need to make explicit the estimation function. There are four different syndromes, and we will assign as an error estimate for each syndrome the following strings. For 0,0, we choose 0,0,0. For 0,1, we choose 0,0,1. For 1,0, we choose 1,0,0, and for 1,1, we choose 0,1,0. Can you guess why we chose this particular map? The idea is that if there is no error, we will output the correct error estimate, but also if there is any error string with just one error. However, this also means that any other error string will be wrongly corrected. Summarizing, the code that we have proposed corrects all error strings of 0 or 1 errors. So this is great. We have a method that can correct up to one error, but how does it behave in real life? Earlier, we said that a good model is the binary symmetric channel. That is to suppose that each bit is prone to suffer an error independently of the other bits and with the same probability p. Then, for our 3-bit words, we can say that the probability that there are no errors is 1p cubed. The probability that there are 3 errors is the probability that the 3-bits flip, which is p cubed. And we can easily complete the rest of the table. Now, what happens if we do not do reconciliation, if Alice and Bob do not try to correct at all? Then what happens is that their strings are correct with probability 1 minus p cubed. The correctness of this naive protocol is the complementary probability, that is 1 minus p cubed. And what happens if we do apply the very simple example that we have been exploring in the previous slides? Then we can correct all single error strings, and we get that the correctness of the output strings is p cubed plus 3p squared times 1 minus p. So perhaps it is hard to immediately see the difference between both calculations. So here we have plotted the correctness of both settings. In blue, no reconciliation. In red, after we apply the example method. So we see that even though we have paid a price, that is, we have sent a message of 2 bits from Alice to Bob, the probability that the string of Alice is different from the string of Bob has been greatly reduced. Okay, so let us conclude this module on reconciliation with some final considerations. First of all, the example that we have described, well, it works, but it does not scale up. If we try to extend the same ideas to a parity check matrix of m by n, we will need a table with 2 to the m entries to decide the output of the estimator module. However, the method of reconciliation that we described can be adapted to use any family of linear codes that you like. You can use LDPC codes, polar codes, turbo codes, etc. You just need to plug a slightly adapted version of the decoder of your favorite linear code in the estimator module. Second, previous to this idea of using linear error-correcting codes, there was some ad hoc two-way protocol proposed especially for information reconciliation. If you had read about QKD in the past, probably you have already encountered this protocol. Its name is Cascade. It has a reasonably simple description and it is not very difficult to implement. However, the original version was suboptimal from the point of view of leakage. Fortunately, there are some nice modifications that make it competitive with the error correction code-based reconciliation. And finally, let us discuss about optimality of reconciliation in the very concrete case of the binary symmetric channel. That is when Alice and Bob hold binary strings and each bit is flipped with probability p independently of the other bits. In that case, the minimum leakage that can be achieved is in the asymptotic limit is proportional to the binary entropy of the bit flip probability p. Since this is the ideal case, in practice, any real reconciliation protocol will leak more information. As an approximation, you can think that 1.1 times the optimal value is a realistic number. If you want to learn more about the nitty-gritty details of reconciliation, you can explore the references that we provide in the notes.